Yeah. So good morning once again. Welcome back to the class. Right. So far we have been discussing about system software. So already we have discussed what the system software is going to do. It is the, as I have told you, a lot of functions are there. So, we can say that yeah, sorry for the interruption. So far we have discussed in the previous class regarding system software. So I have told you that system software, so that is how can I define system software is any program if you want to run, or any function that has to be happen in the system that was done by the system software only, isn't it or not? So we have already defined that system software is a collection of programs that are needed to execute certain applications in the system. So also we have discussed what are the different functions that were performed by the system software. So some of the functions are retrieving and interpreting the commands, the user commands. So I have already also told you the example of it. Example is that is nothing but when you press a command like just control plus C means it's a command, you are giving a command to the system. So control plus C means generally it's a copy option. So simply you are just feeding the command to the system, isn't it? So your system software, according to the command, it will perform the operation. Similarly, the other operations are entering and editing application programs, storing them as files in the memory, isn't it? And managing the storage, that means either storing the files into the memory or into the disk, or retrieving the memory from the, retrieving the files from the memory or from the disk, or transfer the data between disk and secondary storage devices and memory. Okay, and running standard application programs means your word processor, running your word processor, spreadsheets means your Excel sheets, your PowerPoint, everything. So and managing input and output operations, similarly transforming source program, that is converting your source program which is in the high level language into the machine level language, and finally linking your application programs. So all these are the different functions that were performed by the system software that we already have discussed. And also we have discussed which part or what are performing these functions. We are all in all, we are saying that system software is performing the operations, all these functions. So generally, if you come to the conversion or translating the program from high level to machine level language, generally compiler will convert that. That was compiler is a part of the system software. Similarly, if you want to enter or edit an application program, text editor will be provided over there. So text editor will perform the operations like entering and editing the programs. And also we have the files. So whatever the program or sequence of data, whatever it might be, the data will be stored in the form of a file. So a file is also defined as alphanumeric characters or binary data, which was stored in the memory or secondary storage. So generally we retrieve, if you want to retrieve that particular data, generally we give an username to the file, and that file will be stored in the memory or secondary device. So we will be retrieving the data from the file by giving the file name. And Coming to the next part of the system software is the basic and the heart of the system software is operating system. So as I have told you that your operating system is acting as a mediator between the outside world and let us say your system and the outside world, or also it is acting as a mediator between within the system, within different units. So far, this is the heart of the system software, which performs all the operations like storing the data into the memory or into the secondary devices, or retrieving the data from the memory, from the secondary storage devices, or transferring the data between memory and the disk, or initiating any sort of program, managing I/O controls, everything. Everything, almost all the operation will be controlled by your operating system. So also we have defined what is an operating system, isn't it or not? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So here we have gone through an example how the operating system is performing. So for that example, we have taken an example, we have considered a processor, a disk, and a printer. So here we are considering that there is a program and how to execute a program. So how the operating system will perform this operation, let us see once again. So as I have told you, first the application program will be initially will be converted by the compiler from high level language to the machine level language, and it will be stored somewhere in the disk, isn't it? Before your operating system initiates the operation, whatever the application program is there, that was initially converted from machine high level to the machine level language, and it will be stored into some disk. Now your operating system will initiate, the operation will be initiated by transferring the file from disk to the memory. This is how your operating system initiates the operation. Okay, ekkadaina mundu initiate chese the operation initiate chese the operating system endandi, remember that. So ikkada nen program ni execute cheyal anukuntunanu, program ni execute chesadapudu entante mundu initially program have been converted by the compiler and it is stored in the disk. But operating system ఏం చేస్తుందంటే, it will initiate. So whatever the program that you want, it will initiate the retrieval of that program from the disk and to transfer that file into the memory. So when that, after that, your after the transfer completes, now your execution of the program will start. Okay, right? అప్పుడు ముందు రిట్రీవల్ ఆఫ్ ద డేటా ఫ్రమ్ ద డిస్క్ టు ద మెమొరీ ఆపరేటింగ్ సిస్టమ్ ఇనిషియేట్ చేస్తుందండి. వన్స్ మొత్తం ఫైల్ అంతా కూడా ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ అయిపోయిన తర్వాత, అగైన్ ఇట్ విల్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జిక్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఇట్ విల్ ఇనిషియేట్ ద ప్రాసెసర్, దాన్ని కూడా ఆపరేటింగ్ సిస్టమ్ ఇనిషియేట్ చేయాల్సి వస్తుంది. ఓకే, సో నౌ ఇట్ విల్ ఇనిషియేట్ ద ప్రాసెసర్, రైట్? అండ్ లెట్ us say that some part of the program, during the execution of the program, let us say the program needs some data which was again it was stored in the disk. Madhyalo ekkado program madhyalo ekkado data kavalsi vachindandi, malli aa data disk lono memory lono undi, malli appude em chestundante, again your operating system, what it will do is your operating system will again initiates the retrieval of the data from the disk to the memory, and again that data will be given to the processor, and again your processor will be initiated by the OS itself, and your operation or execution of the program takes place. So after the completion of the execution of the program, now if your results are ready, again your OS, if you want to see the result or if you want to take the print out of your result, your operating system itself will initiate the printer. అదే ఇనిషియేట్ చేయాలి. అంటే మధ్యలో జరిగే ఏ ఆపరేషన్ అయినా సరే ఆపరేటింగ్ సిస్టమే ఇనిషియేట్ చేయాలి. ఇక్కడ ఎన్నిసార్లు వాడామండి, ఫస్ట్ డేటాని డిస్క్ నుంచి మెమొరీ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ చేయడానికి ఓఎస్నే వాడాం, ఓఎస్ఏ ఇనిషియేట్ చేయాలి. నెక్స్ట్ మొత్తం మెమరీలోకి ప్రోగ్రామ్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ అయిపోయిన తర్వాత ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ చేయాలంటే నాకు ప్రాసెసర్ కావాలి. సో ప్రాసెసర్ని ఇనిషియేట్ చేసేది కూడా ఓఎస్ఏ. సో ప్రాసెసర్ని వన్స్ ఆపరేటింగ్ సిస్టమ్ ఇనిషియేట్ చేసిన తర్వాత ప్రాసెసర్ విల్ పర్ఫార్మ్ ఇట్స్ ఆపరేషన్. మధ్యలో ఆపరేషన్ మధ్యలో నాకు ఇన్ బిట్వీన్ దట్ ఇఫ్ యువర్ ప్రాసెసర్ వాంట్స్ ఎనీ ప్రాసెసర్ వాంట్స్ ఎనీ డేటా అగైన్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ఎక్స్టర్నల్ డివైస్ ఆర్ ఎక్స్టర్నల్ స్టోరేజ్ ఆర్ ఇంటర్నల్ మెమొరీ ఏదైనా కావాలి అని అంటే మళ్ళీ ఏం చేస్తుందంటే మళ్ళీ ఓఎస్ఏ మెమొరీ నుంచి కానీ డిస్క్ నుంచి కానీ డేటాను రిట్రీవ్ చేయడానికి మళ్ళీ అదే ఇనిషియేట్ చేస్తుంది. చేసి మళ్ళీ ప్రాసెసర్కి ఇచ్చి మళ్ళీ ప్రాసెసర్ని ఇనిషియేట్ చేస్తుంది. మళ్ళీ ప్రాసెసర్ ఇనిషియేట్ చేసిన తర్వాత ప్రాసెసర్ ఆపరేషన్ పర్ఫామ్ చేస్తుంది. మొత్తం ప్రోగ్రామ్ అంతా ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అయిపోయింది అన్న తర్వాత రిజల్ట్స్ రెడీగా ఉన్నప్పుడు అగైన్ యువర్ ప్రాసెసర్ విల్ స్టాప్ ఇట్స్ ఆపరేషన్ అండ్ అగైన్ యువర్ ఆపరేటింగ్ సిస్టమ్ హ్యావ్ టు ఇనిషియేట్ యువర్ ప్రింటర్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు గెట్ ద ప్రింట్ అవుట్. సో ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ వాట్ యు ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు నో ఏ ఆపరేషన్ స్టార్ట్ చేయాలనన్నా ఆపరేషన్ స్టార్ట్ చేయాలంటే దాన్ని ఇనిషియేట్ చేయాల్సింది యువర్ ఆపరేటింగ్ సిస్టమ్ ఉంది. హోప్ డిడ్ యూ అండర్స్టూడ్ దిస్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఎవ్రీబడి?
Yes, ma'am.
Now let us see. ఇదే ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఫిగర్ తో చెప్తాడు. Let us see that. So look at the figure. So just look at the figure, just take down. So this is the figure which demonstrates the user program and OS routines sharing of the processor. That means it will be this is explaining or demonstrating how the operation have been taking place. If you want, just you can take it because నోట్ చేసుకోండి. ఎందుకు అని అంటే దిస్ విల్ బి యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద ఫర్దర్ సెక్షన్స్ ఆల్సో. దీని తర్వాత వచ్చే టాపిక్కి కూడా ఇది ఉపయోగపడుతుందండి. అండ్ ఇది రిఫరెన్స్ కింద ఉపయోగపడుతుంది. జస్ట్ సో ఐల్ గివ్ యూ జస్ట్ 2 మినిట్స్ టైం. జస్ట్ రఫ్లీ టేక్ ద ఫిగర్. Yeah, is it over? So now look at this. So we were just illustrating the same example that what we have seen previously with a figure for easy, for the convenience way of understanding the operation. Now let us see. On x-axis you can see the time periods. I have forgotten here. We have T naught also to write. Please note it down. Here you will be having T naught. And on the y-axis, we can see different units. So this is a program. That means this is this division is a program, and this is OS, and the upper one is disk, and the above one is printer. Okay. So as I have told you that your operation have been divided into different periods of time, Now look at the operation. So as I have told you that here you have T naught. So if you see between T naught and T1, what was happening? Which devices are active? So your OS routine, as I have told you, first of all, your program starts with transferring the data from the disk to the memory, isn't it or not? So now look at here, at time period T naught initially, your OS is initiating. Look at this arrow mark. So your operating system have been initiating your disk to transfer whatever that was present in the disk to the memory, right? So that has taken some time. From T naught to T1, the data transfer have been taking place. So after the completion of the transfer of data to the memory, now again, what the disk will say to the OS that it was over. So again, your OS will be initiating. Look at here, will be initiating your processor. Did you understand? So first, your operating system initiates the disk, right? So there, it takes some time to transfer of the data. After the completion of transfer of the data, again, the operation have been given back to the OS, isn't it? So when OS knows that a complete transfer is over, now again, your OS will initiate. Look at here, initiates the processor. This is either program or processor, whatever it might be. Okay, now look at here. Now what was happening over here? From T1 to T2, your processor have been executing the program. Yes, right. So from T1 to T2, the processor have been performing its operation. Now again at T2, let us say, as I have told you, somewhere your program needs the data from the disk again. There is some data which has to be used by your program or processor. That was stored in the data. So what the processor has sent, so the processor has sent a request to OS again that it wants some data. Now again your OS initiated the disk to retrieve the data. So again from T2 to T3, the data transfer have been taking place. So after the completion of the data transfer, again your disk is saying that data transfer is over. So the request have been sent to the again to the OS. So once the data transfer have been over, your OS is again initiating your processor. Okay. Now from T2 to T3, again data transfer have taken place. Again from T3 to T4, if you see, your processor have been executing the program. Okay. At T4, if the processor says that the execution is over, it will again request your OS. The operation will be again transferred to OS. So now the output is over. Output is ready for to be displayed. So your OS now will initiate your printer. Right. So your OS will initiate your printer. From T4 to T5, the printer operation takes place. So after the completion of the printer, again, the operation is given to OS. Again, your OS will initiate it. So did you understand how the operation have taken place here? Guys, did you understood the figure?
Yes, ma'am.
You can chat. You can respond by raising hand also. So if this is clear, T0 to T1 and T2 to T3, data transfer takes place. T1 to T2 and T3 to T5, execution of the processor operation takes place. T4 to T5, printer operation takes place. Okay. So this is an example how your operating system have been controlling an operation. Not only controlling, there is also, it manages the time only. See, simply it doesn't waste the resources. For example, let us say, can you see the screen or did I lost it?
No, ma'am.
I lost it. Can you hear me at least?
Yes, ma'am.
Just wait for a moment. I'll share it again. Now, can you see the screen?
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Then look at here. See, it does not only controls the operation. Okadan nunchi okadai okati ki okadan nunchi okati ki transfer chestunte ellindandi mee operating system. Meeku ardham ayindi kada ee operation clear ga? Everybody? Everybody? Respond.
Yes, ma'am.
Okkale cheptunnaru.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
So so far I have told you that how your OS have been managing the operation, isn't it? So it does not only manages the operation, the IO operation, but also it will utilize the time also. Look at here how let us see how it is utilizing the time. Look at here, as I have told you, between T0 and during the transfer have been taken place, there is no work for this printer, isn't it? So this printer will be idle. So how it will manage the time? Atla khaliga odilelem kadandi. So andukani operating system em chestundannante, ఇక్కడ నాకు కొత్త ప్రోగ్రామ్ లోడ్ అవుతున్నప్పుడు ఇక్కడ ప్రింటర్ కాన్కరెంట్ గా వర్క్ చేస్తూ ఉంటుంది. అంటే ఇక్కడ ప్రింటర్ ఏం ప్రింటర్ ఆపరేషన్ ఏం జరుగుతుంది అంటే ప్రీవియస్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ యొక్క ప్రింట్ అవుట్ ప్రింటర్ లో ప్రింట్ చేస్తూ ఉంటుంది. మీన్ వైల్ ఇక్కడ నేను కొత్త ప్రోగ్రామ్ ని లోడ్ చేస్తూ ఉంటాను. ఓకే, అలాగే T4 T5 దగ్గరికి వచ్చేటప్పటికి నాకు ప్రాసెసర్ తో కానీ లేకపోతే మిగిలిన వాటితో మెమొరీతో కానీ పెద్ద పని ఉండదండి. సో ప్రింటర్ ఆపరేషన్ జరుగుతూ ఉన్నప్పుడు ఇక్కడ నేను కొత్త ప్రోగ్రామ్ మెమొరీలోకి కొత్త ప్రోగ్రామ్ లోడ్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. అంటే సైమల్టేనియస్ ఆపరేషన్స్ అన్నమాట. వితౌట్ లీవింగ్ ఎనీ యూనిట్ ఐడియల్లీ ఓఎస్ విల్ మేనేజ్ టు పర్ఫార్మ్ సైమల్టేనియస్ ఆపరేషన్. ఇఫ్ ఎ న్యూ ప్రోగ్రామ్ హ్యావ్ బీన్ లోడింగ్ ఓవర్ హియర్, యువర్ ప్రింటర్ విల్ బి ఐడియల్. So instead of leaving this ideally, the OS will initiate this printer to print the previous program. Similarly, during this printing process, generally there will be no work for memory or processor units. So for that purpose, OS will initiate the new program for the transfer of new program into the memory. So this is how the simultaneous operations will be taking place. So this concurrent execution of the programs is known as multi-programming or multi-tasking. So this operation can also be performed by your operating system. So is this clear, everybody?
Not yes, ma'am.
Manages the
yes, ma'am.
Entire operation of the system. Your operating system not only manages the entire operation of the system, but also it is capable of performing your multi-programming or multi-tasking. So this is about the operating system. So far by this it was over about system software. Okay, so far we have seen what the system software have been doing. So by the system software topic is over. Now let us come to the next topic, that is performance of the processor. So let us start that. So can you see this screen? Yeah, wait for a minute. Now can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. Ma'am. Now let us see the performance of the computer or the performance of the processor or whatever it might be. We have some parameters. So before going to the parameters, what is actually performance means? What is that? How you are performing means what are the parameters that are depending upon specifically? So performing means, the measure of performance means nothing but how your system have been executing the program. Yes or no? See, when an application or when a task is given to your system, how can you define the performance? You can define the performance by how fastly your computer have been executing or performing that action. Some of you have raised the hand. Is there any doubt? Anybody have any doubt? Number 409. You can speak out, no problem. 409.
Voice.
Mr. Ram.
Voice.
Okay, I don't think that you have a problem. You can hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Now let us start. So how can you define, how can you measure the performance of a computer? So generally, what we take is you can measure the performance of the computer like seeing how fastly or quickly that it can execute the program. Not only a program, but so far how quickly it was, it was performing the task. Okay, so what are the factors that were that will affect the performance of your system? See, performing a program or executing a program means, first of all, your execution of the program starts with converting the program from your high level language to the machine language, isn't it or not? Ivanni kuda vastayandi. ఫస్ట్ మీరు ఒక ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ చేయాలంటే ముందు మీ ప్రోగ్రామ్ ని హై లెవెల్ లాంగ్వేజ్ నుంచి మెషిన్ లెవెల్ లాంగ్వేజ్ లోకి కన్వర్ట్ చేసుకోవాలి అంటే మీ కంపైలర్ కన్వర్ట్ చేస్తుంది తర్వాత ఆఫ్టర్ ద కన్వర్షన్ యూ నీడ్ టు స్టోర్ ఇట్ సమ్వేర్ ఎల్స్ ఇన్ ద మెమొరీ ఆర్ సమ్వేర్ ఎల్స్ ఇన్ ద సెకండ్ డివైస్ వైల్ యు ఆర్ యూజింగ్ అగైన్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు రిట్రీవ్ ఇట్ ఇజన్ ఇట్ అంటే సింప్లీ your system or your program, I mean, okka daani meeda depend ayyundadandi your performance of the system. So there are several factors where the performance of your computer depends upon. So let us look at here some of the factors. So the first factor is your hardware design. Hardware design is nothing but your compiler, isn't it or not? So the performance of your system depends upon hardware design, instruction set, and compiler. So what sort of instructions that you are using, what hardware design does you have, what sort of compiler do you have? So basically, while executing a program, the performance of your computer depends upon these three factors. Okay, is that clear? Right. So now look at this. So this is again to say the processor cache. So before going to the processor cache, let us discuss something about the performance only. So as I have told you, measure of performance is nothing but how quickly that your system can execute a program. And similarly, I am saying you that your performance depends upon the hardware design, your instruction set, and compiler of the program. Okay, so already we have seen in the previous diagram, if you have a diagram, you have seen that there is totally from T naught to T five, the complete operation have taken place from T naught to T five. Yes or no? Previous figure choose the figure note chase ko manna note chase kuna rende. Note chase kuna ra. Previous operation T naught nunchi T five varku naaku time pattindi. Mottam complete operation adi. Whether it is retrieval of the data from the disk to the memory or after retrieval the processor operation again in between some data if required some data have to be retrieved that one everything after that giving operation for the printer so for everything the total time period that has taken is from T naught to T five so this time period is known as elapsed time okay so I can define the elapsed time as this is a measure of performance of entire computer system got it so whatever you are saying whether it is retrieval of the data from the memory or whether it is a processor operation or whether it is a printer operation for the complete operation in the previous example the time that was taken is between from T naught to T five so the complete operation time is required for the time that was required for the complete execution of the program the complete time whatever the device that was involved that time period is known as elapsed time so how will we defining the elapsed time elapsed time is a measure of performance of entire computer system okay got it note chestunara note chestunarandi right so this time period also will be affected ఆ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ తీసుకుంటే దాంట్లో ప్రాసెసర్ ఉంది డిస్క్ ఉంది ప్రింటర్ ఉంది సో దిస్ అగైన్ దిస్ టైమ్ పీరియడ్ విల్ బి ఎఫెక్టెడ్ బై వాట్ ఎవర్ ది యూనిట్స్ దట్ వర్ ఇన్వాల్వ్డ్ ఇన్ ద ఆపరేషన్ ఓకే ఇజంట్ ఇట్ ఆర్ నాట్ yes
yes ma'am
yes ma'am
so elapsed time we are saying the entire operation there is also one more time period which have to be defined there is a processor time processor time means sum of the time periods sum 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 that means addition the sum of the time periods of what do you say needed to execute the program previous example chuste naaku t1 to t2 t3 to t4 madhyalo maatrame processor work chestundandi t1 ki t2 ki madhyalo unde time period T3 కి T4 కి మధ్యలో ఉండే టైం పీరియడ్ సో ఈ రెండింటిని యాడ్ చేస్తే నాకు ప్రాసెసర్ టైం వస్తుంది సో అది ఎలాప్స్డ్ టైం కి ప్రాసెసర్ టైం కి మధ్య ఉన్న డిఫరెన్స్ అన్నమాట ఎలాప్స్డ్ టైం అంటే ఎవ్రీథింగ్ విల్ కమ్ ఫ్రమ్ T0 టు T5 ఈచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ సింగిల్ టైం పీరియడ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ దట్ వాస్ టేకెన్ అదంతా ఎలాప్స్డ్ టైం పీరియడ్ లోకి వస్తుంది ప్రాసెసర్ టైం పీరియడ్ అంటే ఇండివిడ్యువల్ గా ప్రాసెసర్ పర్ఫామ్ చేస్తున్న ఆపరేషన్ వరకు మాత్రమే వస్తుందండి అంటే ప్రీవియస్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ తీసుకుంటే నా ప్రాసెసర్ ఎక్కడెక్కడ వర్క్ చేస్తుంది బిట్వీన్ T1 టు T2 అండ్ బిట్వీన్ T3 అండ్ T5 సో వీల్ బి యాడింగ్ ఓన్లీ దీస్ టూ టైం పీరియడ్స్ ఓకే సో దట్ వాస్ వాట్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ఎలాప్స్డ్ టైం అండ్ ప్రాసెసర్ టైం Your elapsed time depends upon all the units which were involved in the operation, whereas your processor time depends individually on only on your processor time. Okay, so this is about this is briefly about the just introduction about your performance. So in the next class, we will look at how the performance what is actually the performance okay we can see the example over here we will discuss about this example in the next class and also there are some parameters almost all 8-7 parameters were there So individually we see what are those parameters which will define the performance of your system. So hope today's class is clear for you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And I'm saying you can, if you have any doubt, you can raise the doubt without any hesitation, or even you can raise your doubt after the completion of the class, or ippudaina cheppochandi. Don't hesitate to raise your doubts. You can chat with me personally, or you can chat in the last 5 minutes of the class. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
So that's it for today. Thank you and have a nice day. See, just don't leave this like this. Anyways, I'll give you PDF after the completion of the unit. But what I request is, while the class was going on, please take down the running notes. Like whatever you listen, that will help you as a reference. Okay? So that's it for today, and see you in the tomorrow's class. Thank you. Thank you, everybody, and have a nice day.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.